In class, we developed a linear optimization model for the sandwiches problem. Let's review the steps to set up our model in an Excel spreadsheet. We will then use the solver add-in to find the optimal solution. First, let's enter the linear optimization model in a text box so we can have it for reference. The decision variables are declared as let T be the number of turkey sandwiches to make, let C be the number of club sandwiches to make, the objective is max 4t plus 3c. And the constraints are subject to 0.4t plus 0.5c is less than or equal to 20. Bread. 0.6t plus 0.3c less than or equal to 21. Turkey. (0.2c) less than or equal to 5. Bacon. T greater than or equal to 0. Non-negativity. C greater than or equal to 0. Non-negativity. Now, let's set up our model in the cells of the Excel spreadsheet. The decision variables are T and C. Let's use cells C2 and D2. I have put labels in row 1. I suggest using a color to highlight the cells used for the decision variables. I will use yellow. Next is the objective. I am entering labels in row 4 with the values 4 and 3 in cells C5 and D5. Note that these are the coefficients in the objective function. The actual values of T and C are the decision variables in cells C2 and D2. Another important cell is the objective function itself. We need an Excel formula for this. Let's use cell F5. The Excel formula is equals C5 times C2 plus D5 times D2. I suggest using a different color to highlight this cell. I will use red. Next, we set up the constraints. To show labels for the coefficient, I will use row 7. For the bread constraint, I'm entering 0.4 and 0.5 in cells C8 and D8. We need a formula for the left-hand side of the constraint incorporating the decision variables. Let's use cell E8. The Excel formula is equals C8 times C2 plus D8 times D2. Note that we are using dollar signs on C2 and D2 for absolute references so that we can copy and paste the formula down for the other constraints. C8 and D8 do not have the dollar signs, since we will want relative references for those. I will also enter text for the sign of the inequality. In this case, it is a less than or equal to constraint. On the right-hand side, we have 20, which I will enter in cell G8. For the turkey and bacon constraints, the steps are the same. I am entering 0.6 and 0.3 in cells C9 and D9 for the coefficients of the turkey constraint. This is also a less than or equal to constraint. The right-hand side is 21, which I will enter in cell G9. For the bacon constraint, the coefficients are 0 and 0.2 in cells C10 and D10. The bacon constraint also has a less than or equal to constraint. The right-hand side is 5, which I will enter in cell G10. We still need to fill in formulas for the left-hand side. We will do that after we have all the data set up for all the constraints. For the non-negativity constraints, t greater than or equal to 0 and c greater than or equal to 0 can also be set up in the same way. For the non-negativity constraint for t, I am entering 1 and 0 in cells C11 and D11. Noting greater than or equal to in cell F11 and entering 0 in cell G11. For the non-negativity constraint for C, I am entering 0 and 1 in cells C12 and D12, noting again greater than or equal to in cell F12 and 0 in cell G12. We can fill in the left-hand side formulas for all of the constraints by copying and pasting the formula down from cell E8 to E12. Now, we can set up the model using the solver add-in and solve this sandwiches problem. Select data, then solver to bring up the solver parameters window. Our objective function is in cell F5, so we select cell F5 for the objective. This is a maximization problem, so we keep max selected. Decision variables are set up under by changing variable cells. Select cells C2 and D2. Click Add for the bread constraint. In the Add constraint window, I am selecting cell E8 for the left-hand side. Keeping less than or equal to inequality, and then selecting cell G8 for the right-hand side. Click OK. Click Add for the turkey constraint. In the Add Constraint window, I am selecting cell E9 for the left-hand side, keeping the less than or equal to inequality, and then selecting G9 for the right-hand side. Click OK. Click Add for the bacon constraint. In the Add Constraint window, I'm selecting cell E10 for the left-hand side, keeping the less than or equal to inequality, and then selecting cell G10 for the right-hand side. Click OK. Next, we will enter the non-negativity constraints. Click Add for the non-negativity constraint for T. In the Add Constraint window, I am selecting cell E11 for the left-hand side, changing the greater than or equal to inequality, and then selecting cell G11 for the right-hand side. Click OK. Next, click Add for the non-negativity constraint for C. In the Add Constraint window, I am selecting cell E12 for the left-hand side, changing to the greater than or equal to inequality, and then selecting G12 for the right-hand side. Click OK. Now, the objective function, decision variables, and constraints are specified in Solver. Select the simplex LP solving method, then click Solve. The message appears indicating that Solver found a solution. All constraints and optimality conditions are satisfied. Click OK. Notice that cell C2 is now 25, cell D2 is now 20, and cell F5 is now 160. The optimal solution is to make 25 turkey sandwiches and 20 club sandwiches. This optimal solution provides a profit of $160.